With the first pick in the 1997 WNBA draft, the Houston Comets select Tina Thompson from the University of Southern California.
We were a veteran league when the WNBA started, and it took maybe like 5 or 6 years for the college classes to actually have an impact on how the league was forming. I mean, when you, and like Tamika Catchings and Shamiqua, once they started coming a part of the league, then you saw the impact of the actual draft. And now, you know, we have a lottery, and you know, teams are excited when they get the number one pick because they're going to get the best player.
I think they're getting, you know, they're younger, they're stronger, they're faster, they're gonna get better. But I mean, what we're gonna see more of is what you started. And I'm talking about the dunk in the game.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
So you dunked the ball. It's been very exciting.
What's she gonna do? She dunked it! For the first time in WNBA history, someone has dunked in a game. It's Lisa Leslie with the
There are some players that are coming down the pike that a dunk is like taking a drink of water.
Yeah.
I mean, it's coming every which way.
Parker on the run. We're gonna get a dunk here. Yes! She did it! Lisa Leslie did it first. Candace Parker did it second.
I wasn't sure if it was because I had my child and came back, but when I came face to face with Sylvia Fowles, I knew my time is going to be coming soon. And I knew that. And I had to be honest with myself because I knew that she was strong. She had a certain level of quickness. She could jump. I mean, I had to really give her the fakes and the, you know, I had to think about my move because of her athletic ability. Another player who's really strong like that, I didn't play against her, but I did with the USA team, and that's Tina Charles. Strong pulse player. So when you start to feel these young girls that are coming behind us, they are stronger, they're bigger, and they're coming.
Right, and when they get the maturity that you have,
yes. It's
just going to catapult us into another level of play.
I want to say one thing, Lynette. You came to the city of Carson when I was probably in eighth grade with the Globetrotters. I don't know if you remember that, but I was there, and it was just an amazing moment. You were the only woman with those men and able to do all those things that you did with the ball, and it was very inspiring to me. I don't know if I ever told you that, but I wanted to tell you that now because you've come, your path to come through the WNBA, I know it was towards the end of your career, but there's a lot of things that you did that impacted us that the people maybe didn't know about, but you were truly a pioneer being with the Globetrotters, and it was awesome. Yeah.
Everybody loves
Lynette. She's great.
There's something that I think has been really neat, and that is to go into the mall and see someone, a young girl with a jersey on that has your name on the back. That just didn't happen before, you know. And with all the media exposure, all the games, you know, you got little girls now who are growing up dreaming of playing in the WNBA. I think that's one of the most beautiful things about having the league here in this country, to help develop more dreams in young girls, to help them believe that they can be all that they can be.
I am so thankful that I was able to play in this time era, because we're all, you know, this just happened to be our time. Mm-hmm. We were in the right time era and in the right moment, and I've always taken it so seriously about being a role model. Like, that is so important to me. When I was 7 years old, I would always write my name because I wanted to give out autographs, and I had no idea I would pick up a basketball because I didn't want to get my nails broken. But playing basketball has just been, like, awesome, and to have the WNBA, to have those little girls and little boys that look up to us has meant so much to me. And I've always been thoughtful of my name on the back of my jersey, like to represent and to try to be the best person that I can out there.
Lisa Leslie, who gladly grabbed the torch and said, I will happily be the face of this league. And she's done so in a manner that every fan in this league should be really proud of.
And it's funny because you hear Diana Taurasi and Candace Parker talk about how when they were little kids, they used to sit on the sofa and watch us play. And I think that we paved such a wonderful road for them. And hopefully they can continue to stop and sign autographs and be good role models for the kids we left behind.
The WNBA has been such a blessing, you know, for me, in just opening so many doors and so many avenues and allowing people to really see who we are, not just as athletes and basketball players, but who we are as women. You know, and to be in a position to be a role model for so many young girls out there and, you know, give them hopes and dreams and someone that they can look up to, you know, I'm not sure if without the WNBA any of us would have had all the opportunities that we have in front of us now. And You know, so hopefully the players today can appreciate what they have in front of them and, you know, continue to help the WNBA grow.
A few weeks ago, WNBA tipped off its 15th season. And in that time, it has become the most successful women's professional sports league in the world. Attendance is up, ratings are up, basketball is now the most popular sport for girls in the nation. That's worth applauding. As a father, I thank this team for setting a good example for every young girl with big dreams. Congratulations. We are very, very proud.